Hi, I'm Chris Wardlaw for Auto by Tell, and today we're reviewing the 2015 Hyundai Sonata. Now, the Sonata is completely redesigned for 2015, and while some people might not think that it's as stylish as the car that it replaces, myself included, the fact of the matter is this is one terrific midsize family sedan. Let's take a closer look at the 2015 Sonata, and I'll tell you why. Now, the previous version of the Sonata wasn't everybody's taste. It was a little bit outlandish, but it had a lot of style and character. And that's all been sanded off of this latest version of the Sonata. I've heard a lot of people say this looks like it should be the older car rather than the newer car. Now, part of the reason for that is aerodynamics. Hyundai's got to extract as many miles per gallon out of this new family sedan as is possible. And so part of what you see here is the aerodynamic effect. But rendered in limited trim in this silver paint with these boring 17-inch looking wheels, especially on a gray lit day like today, it's snooze inducing almost. And honestly, it's the worst thing about the new Sonata, the styling. It's just not exciting at all. There's no reason to buy it for style whatsoever. Now, when you buy a 2015 Hyundai Sonata, you've got a choice between three engines. My test car has the most popular one. It's a 2.5 liter, 185 horsepower engine connected to a 6-speed automatic transmission. If you want more horsepower and torque, you can get the Sonata Sport 2.0T. It's got a turbocharged 4-cylinder engine, making 60 more horsepower and 82 more pound-feet of torque than this engine provides. Alternatively, later in the year, if you really want to maximize your fuel economy, Hyundai is going to offer a turbocharged 1.6 liter 4-cylinder engine in this car. It's going to make about the same horsepower and torque as this one, but it's going to offer more fuel economy. That engine is also going to be paired with a new dual clutch automated manual transmission in order to maximize every possible mile per gallon out of every gallon of gas. Now, as far as this engine is concerned, Hyundai has adjusted the way that the horsepower and torque gets delivered. There's less of it, but it's delivered across broader RPM and at lower RPM, so it actually makes the car feel a little bit more energetic than last year's model. As far as fuel economy is concerned, you're supposed to get up to 37 miles per gallon with this on the highway. But in my highway driving, just pure highway driving, I wasn't getting anywhere close to that. I was between 31 and 32 miles per gallon. For the week, I closed out at almost 28 miles per gallon. But again, most of my driving was done on the highway between speeds of 70 and 80 miles an hour. And so I feel like the EPA continues to overstate what you're going to get with a car like this. And the Sonata is no exception. Now, if you need a car with a big trunk, you're gonna wanna look at the Sonata because it's got 16.3 cubic feet of cargo space underneath this lid. You pop it using the button on the key fob or a touchpad located right under the Hyundai badge. Now, as you can see, I've got the full-size suitcase in here. I've got a very large camera bag and my compact folding stroller. It's lengthwise because it won't fit wheels first, unlike some of its competitors. I thought that that was a slight oversight. But otherwise, there's a lot of attention to detail here, and the trunk kind of represents an example of all of the fine tuning that Hyundai's done with this car. From the way that this liner feels, to these plastic covers on the hinges that are there just to make it look nicer, to these really easy seat back release handles, there's a lot of attention to detail here in the trunk. And it permeates the entire car, and it's one thing that really makes the Sonata worthy of examination by midsize sedan shoppers. So we were talking about the little details that Hyundai's really put extra thought into when it comes to the Sonata, and I'm going to show you one of them. In my limited test car, you've got these manual side window shades. And both of my kids are old enough now that they specifically request using these because they're sitting back here in their car seats, especially this time of year because the sun's at more of an angle, the sun's coming in, and they specifically say, "Mom, Dad, can you put the shade up because it's in my eyes?" Now, unfortunately, the existence of these brings attention to the fact that there's not one for the back window. And if you've got a newborn riding in a reverse-facing child seat, you know that if the sun's behind the car and the kid's in here, the sun is just barreling in there right on their face. I really think that on the limited and maybe the top of the line turbocharged 2.0T models, that Hyundai should offer a power rear shade. I don't think it would cost that much extra, and I think it would be a big selling point for parents. Now, as far as rear seat space is concerned, I feel like I'm sitting a little low in the car, but I've got decent thigh support, and as you can see, I've got all the leg room I need in the world. Foot space is terrific. I've got these vents to keep me cool. There's this big center console, or it's not a console, it's a center armrest. Very nicely padded with integrated cup holders. No problem at all back here in terms of space. The EPA actually rates this as a large car, just barely, but still, that's a distinguishing characteristic of the Sonata. And I wouldn't have any problem riding back here for long distances. Now the Sonata's front seats are really comfortable too, and especially if you get the limited with the ventilated seat option. It's pretty terrific up here. Everywhere I want to rest my elbow, it's softly padded, but not thinly padded. And there's a difference there, right? So you can have soft padding, but really thin, so you can feel the plastic underneath. Here you don't feel that. Here you don't feel that. And one of my favorite things about this new Sonata is this beautiful steering wheel with this smooth leather wrap. The way the rim is shaped, the way that these thumb rests are positioned. Everything about this steering wheel, which is the thing you touch most in any car you ever drive, really makes you feel like this car is upscale and that Hyundai really thought about the details. I can't say enough about how great this steering wheel is. The other thing is that Hyundai has fixed the problem that my wife had with the previous generation Sonata. In that car, you couldn't raise the passenger seat up off the floor no matter how much money you had to spend. Here you've got a front passenger seat with a power seat height adjuster, and she's really happy to be riding in this car now. Previously, she would have crossed the Sonata right off of our shopping list. Now there's no way that would happen because she's comfortable. Now, as far as the Sonata's features and controls are concerned, everything's located right where you expect to find it. This is the limited model, so it's fully equipped with all the extras. You can see there's a new bigger touchscreen here. You've got a full array of primary function buttons to control what you see on this screen. Right now it's on radio, but you can change to BlueLink. You can change to the map. Here's your navigation system settings, various applications and other things that you can use like Pandora. And then here's how you can program some of your favorite features of the car. We'll go back to radio here, make sure that's turned down. Climate controls, very simple, easy to use. It's dual zone automatic. And then underneath this covered bin right here, you've got a USB port, an auxiliary input jack, a couple of 12 volt outlets. And what's great about that is in the previous Sonata, if you're familiar with that car, all of this stuff was exposed. So if you left your phone charging and then you walked away from the car, a thief could see that who was walking by the car. Now it's hidden underneath this very nice looking panel. Very nice attention to detail here. You've got plenty of space here for a couple of drinks. This bin works perfectly to hold the keyless fob or to put your phone in. And everything's located exactly the way you want it. I even love the gauges. I mean, there's no nonsense at all about anything in this cabin. Everything is rendered with clarity. It's designed to make this car easy to live with, easy to drive. And there's so much attention to detail in here, from the way that the various panels fit together, to how the gloss and grain here matches the gloss and grain here, to just the way that all of these controls fit and work together. It's almost like this is a luxury car, but it's a mainstream car that you can get for right around 30 grand in this trim level. You can obviously get a Sonata for much less than that. I'm super impressed, and I think that Hyundai definitely deserves accolades for how they've executed this interior. It might not be fancy in terms of its general look. It might not be all that high tech, maybe. I don't know how you feel about it, but it is utterly user-friendly, and I think that's the most important thing when it comes to the way that an interior is laid out. Now, the two core engines for the new Hyundai Sonata aren't necessarily all that different from what they were last year. But Hyundai has adjusted the way that the horsepower and the torque is delivered in order to make the car feel more responsive at more engine speeds. And even though the horsepower rating for the 2015 is a little bit lower than last year, it feels like a stronger car. And that's because it makes more of its power and more of its torque lower and across broader spectrums of the power range. And it just generally makes the car feel more energetic than you might expect given its full-size car status and 185 horsepower rating. Trust me on this, you're not gonna feel, if you get the base engine, you're not gonna feel as though you should have bought the turbo. Now, if you decide to buy the turbo, I've had a chance to drive that model briefly, and yes, it is quick. It's not as high-strung as the previous model was. It doesn't feel as strong as you approach redline as it did last year, but again, the power is more tractable, it's more accessible, and it just feels better to drive in most conditions. The other great thing about the turbo is you get a little bit of a sportier level of tuning than you do in this model, but I'm telling you, again, Hyundai has really sweat all the details. When it comes to the way that this model's steering and suspension and brakes are tuned, it's really remarkable to me. Now, previously, I detested the electric steering in the Sonata. I felt like Hyundai just couldn't get it tuned right no matter how hard they tried. In this model with this engine, I've got no problems whatsoever. It's not a problem at all. The on-center feel is terrific. It's responsive right off-center. It does not feel artificial to me like it did in the previous car. Now, unfortunately, in the turbo, what they've done is they've tried to stiffen it up to make it feel sportier, and the end result is that it just feels more artificial and less responsive. So, in that respect, it's a little bit disappointing, but most people are going to buy this car. You're going to love the steering. And as I said, remember, you're gripping this fantastic wheel all the time. And so, all right, so I've already said how many times. I'm not a fan of how the car looks. Fine, whatever, I'll get over it. The fact of the matter is that if you can get beyond its kind of dull exterior, the Sonata is an amazing automobile in its class. From the quality of the interior materials, to the comfort levels, to the practicality, to how easy all the technology is to use and how intuitive it is. I mean, it's really an extraordinary automobile. And when you add in class-leading warranty coverage, pretty decent fuel economy, top-notch crash test scores, I mean, this car really deserves to be on your shopping list. And if you don't like the way that the car looks, if you do feel like I do, that it's a little bit on the boring side, keep in mind that the next generation Kia Optima is probably going to share most of what makes this car great, but wrapped in that great Kia styling as of late, and you're gonna have what could be a segment killer in that vehicle. But for now, the Sonata definitely belongs on your shopping list. If you're looking for a mid-size family sedan, I highly recommend it. And maybe if you choose a different color and get a different set of wheels, you've solved all of its problems. For Autobytel, I'm Chris Wardlaw, and I'll see you right back here next time.